What's up, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and welcome to another exciting Tech Tip Tuesdays with this guy. So today is all about mapping network drives, so let's get into it. Okay, so on my desktop, I'm gonna right-click on the Start menu, click on Run, type in WinDER, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Windows 10 version 1803 build 17134. I like to show you guys what I'm using throughout the video. All right, so mapping a network drive is super simple. So we are going to open up our File Explorer, and within our File Explorer, if we click on the computer tab, we are going to see map a network drive. So we're gonna click on it, and it's gonna give you this nice little dialog box to type in the folder, which is normally the network shared UNC path. Or if you have everything configured within your home network to do network and sharing, you are able to click on Browse and then click on Network. Now for this example, my network sharing is not enabled, but if your environment shows the same thing, if you click on Network, you're going to get this nice little warning. The network discovery is turned off, blah, 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 blah. I'm gonna show you guys how to turn it on, all right? So on your desktop, we're gonna click on the Start menu. We're going to type in Control Panel, click on Control Panel. And from here, we are going to go inside Network and Sharing Center. And then on your left-hand side, we are going to click on Change Advanced Sharing Settings. And boom, there it goes. Turn on Network Discovery. Now, depending on your environment, this might say private or guest or public. For me, because this machine is part of an Active Directory, like a domain, it's stating my current profile is domain, so I'm going to turn on network discovery, click on save, and then once you go back inside the map network drive, you click on browse, your computers should show up. Now, another way is if you know the IP address of the machine within your network. So if I right click on the start menu and then go to run, and I type in /// with the IP address of one of the computers in my network that is sharing a folder, I'm able to hit OK, and these are all the folders that this particular machine has. So I'm going to double click on sources. I'm going to select that entire path, right click on it, copy it, then go back inside map network drives and paste it. Now when I hit finish, boom, it is mounted. And when I close it and you go inside this PC or within the File Explorer, you're going to see your network location right there. Now, if you're doing this within a home environment, there's a good chance that when you're using your IP address to mount that folder that that computer is sharing, you probably need to enter your username and password for that computer. Like, let's say you want to dismount this particular network drive. Within the computer tab, if you click on map network drives, there's a little arrow. If you click on it and hold it, you're gonna get two options. We are going to pick disconnect network drive, and we only have one network drive, so we're going to select it, hit OK, and it disappears. And that's it, guys. That is how you map a network drive. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this tip. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button. Also, don't forget about punching, elbow, smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.